Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another velocity and acceleration vector problem. This one is the function r of t equals 3 cosine of t times I plus 3 sine of t times j minus 4tk. And remember that when we are looking at velocity and acceleration vectors, the velocity vector is going to be equal to the coefficients associated with I, j, and k of the first derivative of this function, and the acceleration vector is going to be made up of the coefficients on I, j, and k of the second derivative of this function. So really all it boils down to is taking the first derivative and taking the second derivative, pulling the coefficients off of it, and then we're going to calculate speed as well, so you can see what that looks like. So let's get right to it. The first derivative is going to be r prime of t, and that's going to be equal to velocity. So we're just taking the derivative. Remember that the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so that's why we have this negative sign coming out in front here. We end up with negative 3 sine of t times I. And remember that when you're doing these problems, you can basically ignore completely I, j, and k. They're still there, but you can almost like cover them up and pretend that they're not, and just take the derivative with respect to t, leaving I totally alone. So that's what we did. We took the derivative of 3 cosine of t, ignored I, and then just left it right where it was. For the term that includes j here, the derivative of sine is cosine, so we end up with 3 cosine of t, and we just leave that j alone. And then the derivative of 4tk, again, ignore the k completely, just look at the 4t, and of course the derivative of 4t is simply 4, so we end up with minus 4k. And then to find the velocity vector, we take the coefficients in front of I, j, and k, which are really easy to see in this problem. You can tell right away the coefficient on I is negative 3 sine of t, the coefficient on j is 3 cosine of t, and the coefficient on k is negative 4. So all we did was grab those coefficients. Keep in mind, obviously, that if you have a negative in front of one of these terms, you're going to include that sign. It's not just the 4, it's negative 4. But it's anything outside of I, j, and k we grab as the coefficient. So these are the three direction numbers that are going to make up our velocity vector. Now to find acceleration, we're going to take the second derivative, which is simply the derivative of this function that we had here. So the derivative of, and again, same thing, forget about I, j, and k, just take the derivative with respect to t. So the derivative of sine here is cosine, so we're going to end up with negative 3 cosine of t. The derivative of cosine is negative sine, so we bring this negative out in front of the 3 and end up with negative 3 sine of t times j. And the derivative of 4 is 0, it's a constant, so the derivative is 0, so that means we're going to have 0 times k, and that whole term is going to go away, so it disappears. So then we just grab the coefficients again. Obviously, negative 3 cosine of t, negative 3 sine of t, and then because we have no k term, that means that the coefficient must be 0, as we knew from our previous step. So those are the three numbers we grabbed for our acceleration vector. And then to find speed, forget about acceleration for a second, go back to velocity, and we're going to look at the velocity vector here. We're going to take these three coefficients and we're going to square each of them, add them all together, and then put them inside a square root sign. So you can see that we grabbed each one of these, we squared them, so negative 3 sine of t squared, 3 cosine of t squared, and negative 4 squared. We add them all together and we just throw a square root symbol over the top. That is the equation that gives us our speed. So once we've done that, all we have to do is simplify as far as we can, and we'll be done. So simplification is going to look like this. Obviously, we'll get negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9, and we'll end up with sine squared of t, 9 cosine squared of t, and a negative 4 squared is obviously going to give you a plus 16. And that's as far as we can really simplify this one. So we take our velocity vector, our acceleration vector, and our function here for speed, and we put them all together, and that is our final answer. And just one quick thing to note, obviously, I'm letting you know in each of these videos, if you if you get a value, you know, if they ask you to find all these three things and then they say, okay, find velocity, acceleration, and speed at, you know, time 5 or, you know, 5 seconds after the, you know, person started running or whatever the word problem is, you would just plug in 5 for T to each of these, and that'll give you velocity, acceleration, and speed. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!